Hi, Professor Vishal Dalar. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I teach you introduction, construction, working, advantages and disadvantages of deep well pumps. So basically, deep well pump is used to supply the water from the well to the ground levels or our tank. So that's why it is known as the deep well pump. So first we study its introductions. So here you see this image. So first we study introduction, then move towards the construction and working. So deep well pump is a multi-stage centrifugal pump. Multi-stage means more than one impeller is used. Okay, when more than one impeller is used, the impeller are able to arrange either in a series connection or in a parallel connection. So in this deep well pump, the impellers are connected in a series. Means this is the one impeller, second, third, fourth and five. These five impellers are connected in a series. Second point is that the deep well pumps belong to the category of rotodynamic pumps. So in the classification we studied that the pump is two type, positive displacement or rotodynamic. So this deep well pump is coming in the category of rotodynamic pump. It's work on the principle of reverse action of turbine. So it is called as a turbine pump. So this deep well pump is work reverse as a turbine. Okay, so it is also called as the turbine pump. It is generally used for the pumping of drinking water from a depth of more than 8 meters. So why it is called that? Because the water is taken below to the ground levels. So below the ground levels, we are need to put the boring in the ground levels. And after doing this boring, we are supplying this pump below the water levels. And electric motor is outside in this case of deep well pump. In a submersible pump, what happened is electric motor is also putting inside this water. Okay. And in deep well pump, the electric motor is outside. That is the difference between the deep well pump and submersible pumps. If you learn something, then like the video. And next we move toward the construction and workings. Before that, I request to subscribe my channels by pressing subscribe buttons. And also press the bell icon to get continuous notifications. So main component of this deep well pump, the first is the suction pipe with strainer and foot wall. So this is a suction pipe. Okay, so here you see suction pipe, and at the end of the suction pipe we install the strainer and foot wall. Function of the strainer is to avoid the debris from the water entering into this in the impellers. Means some debris is not supplying to the pump. They remove the debris. It is known as the strainers. Next component is impeller assembly. Why it is called impeller assembly? Because more than one impeller are used and these all impeller are connected in the series. That's why it is known as the impeller assembly. Then next component is the rising shaft. So this vertical portion is known as the rising shaft. And the one end of the rising shaft is connected with this impeller and another end is connected with this electric motors. So what the function of this rising shaft? It supplies this mechanical power from motor to the impellers. So that is a more than 8 meter length, so there are possibility of lots of vibrations. That's why here we are putting this number of bearing inside this delivery pipe. Okay, so this is the outer portion is delivery pipe. So water is going through this delivery pipe upper and supplied it to the ground levels. Inside this delivery pipe, the rising shaft is also there and also the bearing is there. Okay. And last one is electric motor. This electric motor is putting on the ground levels. Okay. And in submersible pump, this electric motor already with this impeller and inside this water. And the next is the bearing that we already discussed. Next we move towards the construction and working of a deep well pump. The impeller are key to the lower end of vertical rising shaft. Okay. That we already discussed. This is a vertical shaft, rising shaft. One end of this rising shaft is connected with electric motor. And one end is connected with this impeller. The number of impeller depends upon the head to be required. Means number of impeller used, it's depend on the head requires. Third point, at least 3 meter of suction pipe with strainer assembly placed below the water surface into the water. Means this suction pipe is at least 3 meter height and it is also below to the water level. Means 3 meter below to the water level. It is installed. The pump impellers are connected to the electric motor or any other prime movers by rising vertical shaft. Means this pump impeller are connected with rising star. Okay, and this rising star may be connected with any prime movers. Means either it is connected with electric motor, either it is connected with the IC engines or by solar pump. That is a number of options is available for connecting this rising shaft. The electric motor are usually installed above the ground level. So here we see that ground level is in written. So above this ground level, this electric motor is installed. Next point, the vertical rising shaft is placed inside the delivery pipe and guided through this bearing. So this vertical shaft is installed inside this delivery pipe and it is supported by this bearing. The pressure head developed by the centrifugal action is entirely due to velocity imparted by the water by the rotating impellers. So in introduction we discussed that it is the rotodynamic pump. Rotodynamic pump means the velocity of the water is first increased by using this impeller. So this impeller is increased the velocity of the waters. Then after this velocity energy is converted in the pressure energy in a casing. Okay. Next we move towards the advantages of the deep well pump. The electric motor is outside of the deep well. Therefore no need to sealing of motors and repairing is easily done. Okay. So in this deep well pump, motor is outside so it is easily repairable. In submersible pump what happened? The motor is inside of the well. Okay. So if there is a repairing is required in a motor or motor is stopped working, then we are required to remove the completely pump assembly below the well and we require to the maintenance of this motor. So in deep well pump it is easily repairable because motor is outside. Electric motor is free from erosions and corrosions because it is outside the water, so there is no problem of corrosion. In submersible pump what the happen? The motor is below the water level. Okay. So there is a problem of corrosion is also there. What is the disadvantages of deep well pump? The main disadvantage of this deep well pump is require very long vertical rising shaft. So that is a long vertical rising shaft. It creates a lots of problems. And bearing requires the lubrication. So what is the problem for using the long vertical shaft? That is a vibration is there. Due to vibration noise is created. And that is a power loss is increased. Okay, there is a number of reasons for vertical rising shaft. And the cost is also high because the length of the shaft is very long. So shaft cost is increased. So these are the various disadvantages. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends.